Welcome dear students, today we are going to discuss adsorption. Learning objectives: students will able to understand adsorbent, then understand the mechanism of adsorption on liquid surface and solid interface, then differentiate between different types of monolayers and recognize basic methods for their characterization. Now, what exactly is adsorption? The mass transfer process which involves the accumulation of substance at interface of two phases such as liquid-liquid, gas-liquid, gas-solid or liquid-solid interface. Adhesion of atom, ions and molecules from gas, liquid or dissolved solid to the surface is nothing but adsorption. Adsorbent is the substance which adsorbed on the surface. Okay, this is adsorbent, which is adsorbed on the surface of adsorbent. And adsorbent is a substance on which surface of adsorbent is adsorbed. And adsorption is a spontaneous process where delta G is negative, and adsorption is exothermic process. In that case, your delta H is negative. Now, what exactly principle behind this adsorption? The driving force for adsorption is adsorption is a surface phenomena and consequences of surface energy. The surface of liquid or solid is in a state of strain or unsaturation, which results in unbalanced residual force at the surface. And this unbalanced residual force results in higher surface energy. Consequently, the surface of liquids or solids always have a tendency to attract the retained molecular spaces with which it comes in contact. Means these molecular spaces attracted toward the surface and they get adsorbed on surface or interface. This tendency is responsible for phenomena of adsorption. This tendency of liquids and solids is helpful for the adsorption process. This is the diagrammatic presentation of adsorption. Okay, if you observe this diagram carefully, this is a surface of your adsorbent on which your adsorbent is going to adsorb. Now, spontaneity and exothermicity. Any process can be represented thermodynamically under constant temperature and pressure, and it is represented by Gibbs equation. Okay, you have to keep your pressure and temperature constant, then Gibbs equation delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S, where this delta G is Gibbs free energy, delta H is heat of enthalpy, delta S entropy, and T is temperature. Then adsorption is a spontaneous process and there is a decrease in the surface free energy of the system. So delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S. It is less than zero for spontaneity, okay, at a constant temperature and pressure. At a translation, freedom of adsorbate is reduced when it is adsorbed. Thus, delta S become zero, less than zero or negative. Okay, when it is absorbed on the surface of absorbent, this delta S become negative. Then this negative delta S, when you put into this equation of Gibbs, this negative become a positive, and your final equation will be delta G is equal to delta H plus T delta S. As this spontaneity delta G is less than zero, hence delta H should be negative. Okay, when this G is less than zero, then delta H become negative, and at a spontaneous or at a spontaneity, delta G is less than zero, and exothermic condition delta H is less than zero. Now, adsorption in liquids and solids. This is the diagrammatic presentation of adsorption of liquid on surface. In case of liquid, a molecule in the interior of liquid is completely surrounded by other molecule. Okay, if you observe this molecule, it is completely surrounded by other molecules of liquid, so they are equally attracted into the all direction. But the molecules which is present on the surface of your liquid, they are attracted towards the bulk molecule. Okay, so they are experiencing inward pull. There is a resultant attraction inward because of number of molecules per unit volume is greater in a bulk of liquid than in vapor, and thus it give rise a surface tension to this liquid surface. Hence the particles at a surface and particles at a bulk are in a different environment, thus giving rise to differentiate in a free energy at surface and in a bulk. Okay, means formation of surface tension is because of these molecules which are experiencing inward pull towards the bulk molecule. In case of solid surface, a cleavage of big crystal of solid into smaller units is done to increase surface area. Okay, when you decrease a particle size, ultimately it increases surface area of that particular solid. Due to cleavage of this big crystal into smaller unit, residual forces or vacancies gets generated on this surface of this solids, and occupancy of these vacancies by some other molecular species results into the adsorption. Okay, formation of occupancies on the surface of the solid, and that occupancies filled with the help of other molecule, is nothing but adsorption of the molecules on solid surface. Now we'll see a phenomenon of physiosorption. Molecules and atoms can attach on the surface in two ways. One is physiosorption or physical adsorption, in which there is a van der Waals interaction between adsorbent and substrate. For example, dispersion or dipolar interaction. Van der Waals interaction are long range but are weak energy released. When particles is physiosorbed is of same order of magnitude as the enthalpy of condensation, and such a small energies can be absorbed as the vibrations of lattice and dissipated as thermal motion, and a molecule bouncing across the surface will gradually lose all its energy and finally adsorbed on the surface. This is diagrammatic representation of physical adsorption. The molecules with small energies can be absorbed as a vibration of lattice, and the thermal motion and molecule bouncing across this surface, and it start to gradually adsorb. Next phenomena, chemisorption. It is also known as chemical adsorption, in which molecules or atoms stick into a surface of adsorbent by forming a chemical bond. Okay, in a previous method they are just adsorbed, there is no formation of bond in between them. At occupancy they are just adsorbed, so it is known as the physiosorption or physical adsorption. But in case of chemical adsorption, your adsorbent and adsorbate forming a bond, chemical bond, so it is known as the chemical adsorption, and tends to find site that maximize their coordination number with the substrate. In chemical adsorption, molecule may be torn apart at the demand of unsatisfied vacancies of surface atom, and existence of molecular fragments on a surface as a result of chemisorption is one reason why solid surface catalyze reaction. Now if you look at this diagram, this blue hydrogen bond, blue adsorbed on the surface of the host green, and red is acts as a catalyst. Okay, this is host material, green molecules are host material, R is nothing but red color is showing catalyst structure, and this water molecule form a hydrogen bond with your host molecules, and they get adsorbed on a surface of your host molecule or surface of host because of chemisorption. Okay, there is a formation of chemical bond in between molecules of water and molecules of your host. Then here oxygen molecules, which are red in color, adsorbed on a metallic surface of platinum. Okay, these purple colors molecules are of platinum, and oxygen molecules are adsorbed on this platinum molecule. Again a cobalt molecules are there, these green color balls are of your cobalt molecule, they are also adsorbed on platinum surface along with oxygen. Now what exactly difference between physical adsorption and chemical adsorption? In case of physical adsorption, it is not too much specific, no electron transfer is there. Then although polarization of adsorbent may occur, a rapid, non-activated and reversible, no dissociation of adsorbed species, then monolayer or multilayer is formed on the surface of your adsorbent, only significant at relative low temperature, enthalpies are in a region of negative kilojoule per mole. As the temperature increases, process of this physical adsorption decreases because it increases kinetic energy of molecules. That's why when you increase a temperature, ultimately physical adsorption decreases. Then chemical adsorption is highly specific because there is a formation of chemical bond, electron transfer is there during bond formation, then activated adsorbent get activated, it may be slow or irreversible, it may involve dissociation, then formation of monolayer only. Why formation of monolayer only? Because there is a formation of chemical bond in the molecule of your adsorbent and adsorbate, and that's why there is a formation of monolayer. Then it is possible over a wide range of temperature enthalpies are in a region of negative 200 kilojoule per mole. With increase in a temperature, this chemical adsorption increases and then decreases. This is graphical representation of chemical adsorption. When you increase the temperature, initially it increases and then it starts to decrease. But in case of your physical adsorption, as you increase the temperature, adsorption get decreases. Now we'll discuss factors affecting on this adsorption. First factor, temperature. Adsorption is an exothermic process. Therefore, accordance with Lee-Chatelier principle, the magnitude of adsorption should increases with decrease in temperature. And it is in the case of physical adsorption, but in case of chemical adsorption, first increases with rise in temperature and then start to decrease. Means depending upon nature of your adsorption, this temperature will affect. Second factor is pressure. With increase of pressure, adsorption increases up to certain extent and till you will get a saturation level of your adsorbent is achieved, and no more adsorption takes place no matter how high pressure is applied. Okay, after saturation there is no effect of pressure on adsorption process. Then surface area, it is of surface phenomena, therefore adsorption capacity of adsorbent increases with increase into the surface area. Okay, surface area is directly proportional to your adsorption. More, if you have a more surface area with you, more will be adsorption. Smaller the size of particle of solid adsorbent, more is extent of adsorption at its surface interface. Okay, when adsorbent molecules are having a less particle size, more molecules will be adsorbed at the interface. Then next factor, activation of solid adsorbent. Activation of adsorbent surface done as so as to provide more vacant site on the surface. Okay, then this can be done by breaking a solid crystal in a small pieces and breaking a lump of solid into powder or subdividing the adsorbent. Means your adsorbent should have a more surface area, and when you will get more surface area, when it is having a less particle size. Okay, and you have to activate it to create a more vacant space on its surface, and that's why it is helpful to adsorb more molecules on its surface. Now we'll discuss adsorption at liquid interface. Surface free energy is defined previously as work that must be done to increase surface by unit area. Then as a result, such expansion, more molecule must be brought from bulk to interface. Then more work that has to extend it to achieve this greater in surface free energy. Certain molecules and ions, when dispersed in a liquid, move of their own accord to the interface. This concentration at interface then exceed and their concentration in a bulk of liquid. And obviously, a surface free energy and surface tension of system are automatically reduced. Means when you increase concentration of your surfactant increases, ultimately it surface free energy and surface tension is reduced. And such a phenomena where added molecules are partitioned in a favor of interface is termed as adsorption. And more correctly, it is positive adsorption when it reduces surface tension and surface free energy. But other material like inorganic electrolytes are partitioned in favor of bulk and leading to a negative adsorption and corresponding increase in the surface free energy and surface tension. Okay, when your material is partitioned in favor of bulk, then there is a negative adsorption. Adsorption, as will be seen later, can also occur at a solid interface. Adsorption should not be confused with absorption. Absorption is different phenomena and adsorption is different phenomena. The former is solely a surface effect, whereas absorption, liquid or gas being absorbed and penetrate into capillary spaces of absorbing medium. Where in case of adsorption, it is adsorbed on a surface of your liquid or solid. The taking up of water by sponge is absorption, and concentrating of alkaloid molecule on a surface of clay is adsorption. Okay, this is difference between absorption and adsorption. When your sponge is absorbing water, means water is entering inside this sponge because of the capillary action, and this phenomena is known as the absorption. And when you are concentrating this alkaloid molecule on surface of clay, it is known as the adsorption. Then we'll discuss adsorption isotherm. Adsorption process is usually studied through graphs known as adsorption isotherm. Amount of adsorbate on an adsorbent as a function of its pressure and concentration at a constant temperature. Adsorbate plus adsorbent will give you adsorption. According to Lee Charter principle, on application of pressure, the equilibrium will shift in a direction where number of molecules decreases. Since number of molecules decreases in a forward direction, that is direction of adsorption, with increase in a pressure and forward direction, equilibrium will be achieved. And in given adsorption isotherm, after saturation pressure, that is PS, adsorption does not increase. Okay, if you observe this graph, when you are increasing pressure along with your X by M, when you achieve the saturation level, graph will be straight line. Okay, because all your adsorbent get adsorbed. Vacancies on a surface of adsorbent are limited. At saturation pressure, a stage is reached when all sites are occupied, and further increase in pressure does not increase adsorption extent. Okay, means your adsorbent is having a limited space. Depending upon molecules of your adsorbent, it is having a specific site, and when all these sites get saturated, then there is no more site to adsorb your adsorbate on the surface of your adsorbent. So when you are increasing pressure, there will be no adsorption process because all sites of your adsorbents are fulfilled. And so this graph is showing us that straight line after certain limits. Okay, this is saturation point or saturation pressure. After that, there is no site is available, so there is no effect of pressure on this adsorption. Now this adsorption isotherms are having it four types: friendly adsorption, Langmuir adsorption, Temkin isotherm, and BT isotherm. Okay, friendly isotherm, Langmuir isotherm, Temkin isotherm, and BT isotherm. In adsorption isotherm, plot drawn between amount of gas adsorbed on x-axis against equilibrium pressure or concentration. On x-axis, at a constant temperature, a significant increase in adsorption will with increase in pressure followed by leveling off. And leveling off is due to the saturation of available chemical groups or sites. Or entire surface is covered by monolayer molecules. Okay, when a single layer of your adsorbate get adsorbed on surface of adsorbent, then it is known as the formation of monomolecular layer. Same as a Freundlich and Langmuir adsorption isotherm. Example: adsorption of nitrogen or oxygen on charcoal. This is diagrammatic representation of adsorption isotherm type 1. Now we'll see one by one. Type 2 adsorption isotherm, it is having a sigmoidal shape. Then this type of isotherm is observed when gases undergo physical adsorption onto a non-porous solids. First, inflection point represent formation of monolayer, and further increase in pressure result into the multilayer formation. A constant small b in BET equation is greater than 2. And when monolayer is formed, the plot is reduced to Langmuir isotherm. Example: adsorption of nitrogen on platinum catalyst or ferrous catalyst. Iron catalyst. When you think about this type 2 adsorption isotherm, it is characterized by inflection point, and this inflection point is formed because of this formation of monolayer on a surface of your adsorbent. And after that, when you increase amount of your adsorbent, it start to form multilayer, and that's why your graph is showing sigmoidal shape. Now we'll see third type of adsorption isotherm. Heat of absorption of gas in a first layer is less than latent heat of condensation of successive layers. In BET equation, constant B is smaller than 2. It is observed very rarely. Example: adsorption of bromine on silica or alumina. And characteristic of this adsorption isotherm type 3, there is a formation of there is a weak interaction between your adsorbent and adsorbate, and it is most associated with this non-porous or the microporous adsorbent. Low adsorption at low pressure due to the weak interaction between this adsorbent and adsorbate. An accelerated uptake at a high relative pressure because of strong adsorbate interaction after adsorption at the primary sites. Okay, one more example of this type 3 adsorption isotherm, that is adsorption of nitrogen water on carbon. Now we'll discuss next adsorption isotherm, that is adsorption isotherm type 4. In this isotherm, adsorption of gases on porous solid is there, okay, and capillary condensation is there. First point of inflection, when extrapolated to zero pressure, represent monolayer formation during this adsorption process, and this point represent amount of gas required to form the monolayer. And further adsorption is due to multilayer formation and capillary condensation with the pore of your solids, and limiting value is due to the saturation of vapor pressure. This is diagrammatic representation of type 4 adsorption isotherm. Example of this adsorption isotherm, that adsorption of benzene on silica gel, then condensation of gases on porous solids. Type 5 adsorption isotherm. It is quite similar to type 3 isotherm. It shows convex curve. It is characteristic of weak adsorbent and adsorbate interaction. Then capillary condensation and adsorption reaches a limiting value before vapor pressure is attained. It is observed very rarely. Example, adsorption of water vapor on charcoal at 100 degree centigrade. The heat of absorption of gas in first layer is less than latent heat of condensation of successive layer. So adsorption reaches to the limiting value before the saturation point is reached. Now we'll discuss Freundlich isotherm. Now empirical equation for representing isothermal variation of adsorption of quantity of gas adsorbed by unit mass of solid adsorbent with pressure is Freundlich adsorption isotherm. X by m is equal to k p raised to 1 by n, or you can write it as x by m is equal to k into c raised to 1 by n. Okay, this is equation for Freundlich adsorption isotherm, where this x by m is adsorption per gram of adsorbent, which is obtained by driving amount of adsorbate by weight of adsorbent. Okay, x is amount of your adsorbent by a weight of your adsorbent is represented by m. Okay, p is nothing but pressure. K and n are constant whose values depend upon adsorbent and gas at particular temperature. Now, taking logarithm of Freundlich isotherm, we can write this above equation as log of x by m is equal to log k plus 1 by n log p. Freundlich isotherm correctly established a relationship of adsorption with pressure at lower values. This is a diagrammatic presentation of Freundlich isotherm. When you plot graph x by m versus p, it increases adsorption when initially you are increasing pressure, and after that, after achieving saturation point, it will give you a straight line graph. Okay, when you plot x by m, so log of x by m versus log p, then it is giving us straight line, but graph is not passing or line is not passing through the origin. The limitation of this Friendly's isotherm failed to predict adsorption capacity at high pressure. We can determine adsorption at low pressure only by using this Friendly's equation or by using Friendly's isotherm. At higher pressure, we cannot determine adsorption capacity of your adsorbent. Then next type, that is Langmuir isotherm. In 1960, Langmuir proposed another isotherm, Langmuir adsorption isotherm. Now it is based on different assumptions, one of which is dynamic equilibrium exists between your adsorbed gas and free gases molecule. He was believing on facts that every active site of adsorbent acts in the same way an adsorbate is absorbed on a surface of liquid to form a monolayer. And one more thing, a rate of adsorption is proportional to concentration of adsorbate and the number of unoccupied sites available on your adsorbent. A plus M is equal to AM surface. Where AG, unabsorbed gaseous molecules. M surface is equal to unoccupied adsorbent surface. That is AM is equal to adsorbed gaseous molecules. The extent of surface coverage is normally expressed as functional coverage theta. Theta is nothing but number of adsorption sites occupied or number of adsorption sites available. The rate of change of surface coverage due to adsorption is proportional to partial pressure P of gas and number of vacancies. The number of vacancies you can write N into bracket 1 minus theta, where N is total number of sites, Ka and Kd rate constant of adsorption and desorption. Then rate of adsorption, that is d theta divided by dt, is equal to Ka into P N into bracket 1 minus theta. N is total number of sites, Ka adsorption constant, and theta is number of adsorption sites occupied, and d theta by dt is nothing but rate of change of surface coverage due to the adsorption. The rate of change of theta due to desorption is proportional to number of adsorbed species. Desorption means your separation of your adsorbent and adsorbent, and this rate of desorption is totally depend upon how much adsorbate is adsorbed on adsorbent. So you can write this rate of desorption d theta divided by dt is equal to negative kd n theta. This equation will give you rate of desorption. At equilibrium, there is no net change. So theta is equal to Kp upon 1 plus Kp. At lower pressure, Kp is so small that factor 1 plus kp is denominator can almost be ignored and your Langmuir equation will reduce to theta is equal to kp. At high pressure, kp is so large that factor 1 plus kp in denominator is nearly equal to kp and your Langmuir equation will become kp theta is equal to kp upon kp is equal to 1. Okay, when this kp value is small, then your equation will be theta is equal to kp. But when this kp value is large, value of your theta will become 1. This is diagrammatic representation of Langmuir isotherm. Now, limitation of this Langmuir isotherm, it is also valid at low pressure only. Then BET isotherm, it is widely used isotherm dealing with multi-layer adsorption. Multi-layer adsorption means number of layers of your adsorbate form on adsorbent. It is known as the multi-layer adsorption. So one layer is formed, then second layer is formed, and then third layer is formed. And in case of monolayer, only single layer of your adsorbate is adsorbed on a surface of adsorbent. In physical adsorption, if initial adsorbed layer can act as a substrate, instead of isotherm leveling off to some saturated value at high pressure, it can be expected to rise indefinitely. Under the condition of high pressure and low temperature, thermal energy of gaseous molecule decreases. And more gaseous molecules would be available per unit surface area of adsorbent, and this leads to multi-layer adsorption. Equation for BET isotherm, V upon V monolayer is equal to Cz into bracket 1 minus Z into bracket 1 minus C Z, where Z is equal to P upon P star. P star is vapor pressure above layer of your adsorbent that is more than one molecule thick and which resemble a pure bulk liquid, where V monolayer is a monolayer coverage volume and C is constant. When C is greater than 1, then your BET isotherm takes a simple form. Then your equation will be V upon V monolayer is equal to 1 upon 1 minus Z. Now this is diagrammatic presentation of BET isotherm. When you plot graph volume by volume versus Z value. Now commonly used adsorbent, silica gel is there, activated alumina is there, activated carbon is there, then polymer resins are there, clay, then zeolites. These are the commercially used adsorbent. Then application of adsorption, separation, purification of liquid and gaseous mixture, bulk chemicals, isomers and air, drying gases and liquids before loading them in industrial system, then removal of impurities from liquid and gas media, recovery of chemicals from industrial and vent gases, and water purification. Okay, these are the applications of adsorption. Thank you.